Hello,
Hello.
how are you? Thank you everyone for joining. I am so pleased to see everyone today. We're all here celebrating the rise of Phoenix, a film that we've all been part of. It's a film that tells the story of the Paralympic movement and how competitive sports have impacted our lives and the lives with people with disabilities. Now it's going to be streaming on Netflix, and this film is about the power of sport. And that's what we're all here to talk about. So first, I would like to start with describing ourselves. I'm Tatyana McFadden. I'm 31 years old. I have long brown hair, brown eyes. I'm very strong as a wheelchair racer.
My name is Jean-Baptiste Alaize. I am adopted in France. I am 29.
Hey, my name is Ntando Mahlangu. I'm 18 years old. Right now, I'm wearing a bluish shirt. I'm a double amputee, so I lost both of my legs at a younger age. And yes, I'm from South Africa.
Hello, everyone. I am Matt Stutzman. I am 37 years old. I was born without either my right arm and hand and my left arm and hand. My strongest attribute has to be my legs because I do everything with my feet.
I'm Bebe Vio. I'm from Italy. I'm blonde. I got green eye. I'm a wheelchair fencer. I don't know. I just speak so much, so I'm sorry for that.
My name's Pintari. I am 35, about to be 36. I've got blue eyes. I love sports, and this is one of the most amazing projects that I've ever been part of. And I'm honored to be on a call with such amazing, strong people.
Kind of the first and big topic that I kind of want to talk about is, it's the one thing that we all have in common is that like sports saved our lives and it's therapy. And I also feel like it's kind of have become a responsibility for us to take things further, right? In our own communities and our own countries. So do you think that sports can give voice to the oppressed?
Sport yep. plays a big part in my life, and it has changed for me to evolve into the person that I've never thought I would be, but then into someone that I want to be one day. So yeah, sport definitely can change how people see things. I think, you know, this film that we are busy doing right now, it's going to play a big role.
In 2004, it wasn't as Paralympics wasn't known what it's like today. People didn't really talk about, you know, in the United States, the Paralympics, and it wasn't celebrated when we came back home. When I returned for my first Paralympics in 2004 with two medals around my neck, I entered into high school just to join the high school track team, but I wasn't allowed to join. I wasn't given a uniform, and I was not allowed to work out with the team, and I was not allowed to compete with the team. So all at the age of 15, with the support of my parents, I sued the county of my school system the right to compete alongside of able-bodied high school athletes. And we prevailed in the county and in the state, and now it's federal law, and it mandates and requires school to allow people with disabilities to join high school sports equally. And I had to fight this at the age of 15, right after the 2004 Paralympics. So we still have, you know, a long way to go when we talk about disability and rights and things that we've had to face. Harry, you've done such played such a huge role in combating institutional inequalities. This is why I was so happy that you were also really part of this movie, because I've seen what you have done to the Invictus Games, and it normalized disabilities. It normalized acceptance, and it was building understanding.
Sport helps rehabilitate and recover the individual, but while the individual is recovering, it's changing people's perceptions and change, like the amount of letters and emails that we got from that first Invictus Games in London, thousands of people writing in saying, oh, I've had a broken back for 4 years. Now I've just seen someone who should be dead run the 100 meters. Like yep. now I know what my goals are. For me to see the difference or the power that sport has in changing people's lives, both within the sport, but also in the stadiums, it's it's humbling and inspiring all at the same time. I think with COVID and everything else that's happening at the moment, people need to be taught resilience, and your stories and the strength that you guys show is incredible. And I think that needs to be seen more. Just as you said, Tatyana, it needs to be spoken about more to try and get rid of the stereotyping, to get rid of those preconceptions.
I know for me, I love handicap. For me, I'm normal. You say, oh, it's very complicated for this guy because he have only one leg, blah, blah, blah. But I go more far to people that have two legs. You have handicap, let's go. It's possible.
When I was 11 years old, I went to the state, to the government, and I asked them, okay, guys, I don't have a lot of money. Can you help me? Can you give me like a wheelchair and a prosthesis to be able to practice fencing? And they told me that I was not good, because with my situation, I could never like achieve some sports results. And my family was like, okay. My father invented me the prosthetics for playing fencing. Oh. Because there was no one in the world. And then from that moment, we realized how much our family was like reborn again, thanks to the sport. And so my family created like a non-profit association. Our task is to help a little guy with amputation to be part of the sport. And now we are like 35 guys from 3 years to 30. All of us with some amputation, all of us doing some kind of sport. And there is this little child, he's 6 years old and he's without a leg. And he had never run in his life before the prosthetics that we gave him. Started running without waiting the teacher for teaching him like how to run. I don't know, but he saw all his friends running, so he just put his leg long and he just starts running, and he was not stopping. And when you see a little guy doing these things like with a super big smile, super happy, and on the other side you see the family, you see the parents on the back. They were like, their parent was like super happy, was crying because they have never seen their little child running, and he had never seen him like super happy like this. I think that this little thing can change the world, because this guy now, he's super strong. He feels like he's a superhero.
I think that sports does have the power to change the world and to normalize disability. And the more we talk about it, the more we'll create acceptance. Mm-hmm. And I think that's the common thing that we're finding here. So I kind of, Matt, I kind of want to still move on to talk about the question of the inequalities that you've had to face. I mean, you told me so many numerous, stories about, just trying to get a job, with a disability. Can you kind of like talk about that a little bit?
In 2010, I couldn't get a job. I would go in and apply, and on paper I qualified, but because I had no arms, I look different, I would never get that chance to just provide for my family. I remember specifically one guy said if I had prosthetic arms, he would hire me. Well, I haven't had prosthetic arms since I was like probably 7 or 8, right? And this is the life I chose. What changed was once archery and the Paralympics happened was that now I do have that voice. So now that I'm back in the same town, I can go to the same places that would never even give me a chance before. And if I wanted to work there, I know that they would all give me a chance. And so what I've learned is that it gives me this opportunity to not only educate people, but to even possibly help out other people that are in the same scenario that need to understand that, we can do just as much as everybody else, and to not look at it or not to look at us as just being somebody with a physical disability. We are very capable of doing everything that everybody else can do if we're just given that chance to do it.
You know, it's possible for you, you compete with Olympics athletes because you are so strong. Maybe it's possible
maybe
for you.
Maybe you could be in the Olympics, Matt.
Yeah. So they shoot a different type of bow. But in the United States, right after my loss, in Rio, I decided to switch to able-bodied only competitions. So in 2017, I actually beat the entire United States able-bodied team and won the national championship.
Wow.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
Is there someone who began doing like archery with legs, even if they had the arm, just because you did it? and you do it like better?
You have to be flexible,
baby. I fit in all the rules and you know, so if they want to shoot with their legs, they can.
This won't be as good as with their arms. How have you guys been doing during this time? Obviously, the postponement of the Olympics and Paralympics. What are your hopes for Tokyo next year?
I looked at it as I get a whole nother year of making sure I'm even better than I was this year. So they all better watch out. Like, that's how I took my mindset when it comes time for next year when we do have the games, because in my mind, the next year's games are going to be even better than probably what they were going to be this year, just because the whole world's going through this. It'll be probably one of the first times we all get together and enjoy together again. And it's going to be huge and amazing. And so I want to make sure that I was the best that I've ever been in my entire life.
Going back to the gym after the quarantine, I think I'm much more focused now on what I want to do, on how I'm going to be in Tokyo next year.
I was kind of the same as you, baby. I found that little silver lining. It kind of allowed me to rest, recover a lot better. I use that time to redo my nutrition, work on my sleep, just really work on myself. So I feel like I'm going to be a different person going into Tokyo next year. So I'm happy that you found the same as well.
For me, it's going to be a challenge because next year I'm doing my final year in high school. So it would have been nice for me to go this year. But then, you know, it's 1 year experience that I gained to go into next year. So yeah, I think it's going to be something nice. It's going to be the best. You know, obviously, me going for the gold also, you know, after Rio, having to get the silver medal. So, you know, I'm pushing for certain goals also, but also, you know, I'm going there to enjoy, you know, athletics in whole. You know, it's all about enjoying every single moment, because you never know when it's going to end, you know. So while we edit and while we're busy, you can do it, you know, why not enjoy it and, yeah, take the best out of it, yeah.
Yeah, I 100% agree.
I have lost my sponsorship in France because they say, oh, we don't have Olympic Games this summer, but we need to stop with you because we don't know, it's not make sense to continue with you because we don't have Olympics. But for me, it's complicated because I've lost my job. I have lost my sponsorship. Yeah. How stay focused, you know. I know me with my past, with my story. I know how coming back, you know. But now I need just keep time with my family, with my friends. Sometimes it's good for the body stay more relaxed, more off. Because we walk every time with the body, and then it's good for a break, keep a break, you know, for next year, for next 2 years.
Tokyo will be ready for us regardless. I've been to Tokyo last year for the marathon in March, and just getting a little taste of it, just a year before the games, well, supposed to be this year, the city was like ready, you know, everything was accessible. They had great ramps everywhere. The cabs were wonderful and taking our wheelchairs. When you went to go check into a hotel room, they said, oh, you know, you don't ask for an accessible room or a handicap room. They call it, oh, they said, oh, it's a universal room. Would you like your universal room? So it was like, it was huge. It was massive. And the bed moved up and down and this direction and that direction. I mean, the shower was like huge. So I know it's going to be another year away, but I'm so excited to see the city. I think that they're going to do just a beautiful job innovating technology and accessibility. So what are your hopes at this film would do? I mean, anyone can go, I can start. I hope that this film changes the world. I hope that it brings, as you were talking about, maybe more sponsorships to the Paralympics. I hope it changes attitude and perception of disability. I hope it normalizes disability and normalizes acceptance.
If you know about Paralympic game, if you know about Paralympic athletes, you're gonna fall in love with it. So I just think that people need this film because they are gonna fall in love with it. And they're gonna fall in love with the Paralympic games in general, like Paralympic sports in general. It is needed because people need to open their eyes about it.
The story is about, you know, bringing people together. And I think that, you know, I hope that this film can do that and bring people together.
I don't think the word hope should be in there. I think it, you know, this film will change the perspective on how people see the Paralympics and the games. And this film will bring the world together so they understand what we're trying to do as far as changing the world. I don't have any hopes for it because I know it's going to be amazing, and I know anybody who sees it, it's going to be automatically change on their views and how they see things, and it will affect them, whether they're watching it to just for fun or if they're actually watching it to learn something.
Across the world, people are experiencing unprecedented challenges with themselves, with their families, with the way that they live, their environment that they're stuck in. And I think, I hope, my biggest hope is that people watch this film and go, no matter how hard my life is, no matter how hard a day or a week can be, this is what I aspire to. Not just for me, but for my family and all the loved ones around me. It is that element that I think will end up changing the world. So well done. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. It was amazing.
Bye. I hope you guys have a great day.
Paralympics is something almost magical.
Being a part of something bigger than just yourself was incredible.